Back to another episode of Damn Studio. This will be number 21. I don't care what anyone may have told you last time. It's episode 21. Now, that still puts us in the third season of work for our show. And I've had a few things going on. What you can see here is a little test shot for an office area we're going to need for a couple scenes we're going to do on our own project we're working on. Kind of a either be a series that we'll throw in on the show here, or it's going to be, maybe, who knows, a full feature if it's interesting enough. In that case, we'll put it on the line for everyone to see. That's, of course, after the loyal viewers here that watch our show, we'll see it on this. Got to do a half damn studio, half the new thing. But, of course, it's a process we build to. We've got a script. I already rolled out the script. Talked to some people for talent, broke down some props, getting some basic shoot locations, things like that. Storyboard, gotta have a storyboard, otherwise you'll screw up on your camera shots. Let's see, some props, got some different stuff we see here. Should be fun, it's a nice educational process, and you know, it's not like I'm gonna get fired if no one likes it. It's the advantage of doing public access. Try whatever the hell I feel like. Now, let's see what I got going on here. Should mention, say hi to Nat over there at the film, the BSA Sci-Fi Club. Doing their, they do just some film festival. They get together for some films. There's Monthly Zine Beginner Production. But what you can do is go to www.tcif3.com. That'll give you some information if you're locally want to see about getting involved in some stuff. Actually, a friend of Nick's, who is the guy in charge over there at Charter, he also does that drive-in, Demented Drive-In. Entertaining. I enjoyed it. Oh, let's see. We also should mention today's episode, what we're going to do is bring you my production assistant, camera person, also known to some of you as Frau Morgan, put together her own little starter film. And we thought since we were starting out, first thing she's going to do like this, she should use where it all started. Silent film style. Horror film. Because that's just what she likes. Lots of, weird, twisted stuff. But we got that today with River of Worms. It's already been online. We're going to put it here on the show for you to watch. And, let's just keep you waiting to see. And, We're going with that right off the bat here. Instead of making you wait. We like you that much. So, see you in a little bit. playing around a little bit here. Okay. Now, well, if you, I hope you enjoyed that. Later on, we'll give some website stuff. You can get a hold of her, let her know. Just a simple thing, first process. I actually shot it all in one day. Took a little longer to edit it, especially the animated parts. But, you know, we just wanted to play around a little bit, explore the things, see how it was. You know, you gotta crawl before you can walk. That's where we learn from. She's got other films later on building up. Let's just say, the whole river of worms into the fishing, into the large hooks being used to catch people. That'll be fun later on. But, okay, what we've got is, of course, a throwback to one of my old show I used to do. Gotta get them credit for the years of work they put into us and the awards we won. We got a flashback. Guess it'd be number 21, so I've been doing every one with every episode. It's kind of a combination of some of the few of the old people used to show. It's a throwback to our when we lived there in Greenwood, I believe it was, and we were working out of our own basement. We've shown some of the stuff before, but as I'm editing through stuff, cleaning up stuff, giving stuff one more chance to be seen on the air before I turn it to DVD and stack it to the storage. But, you know, the old stuff's on VCR tapes, so I've got to convert it all. And the next thing you know, there we'll have that all finished. And the idea is once we get through everything that we've done before, including all the art samples from other people, from the other shows and that, we'll be going more to newer things. But I wanted to do a final connection to where it all started and give you a little chance to get, you know, working again. Had kind of illnesses there in between and had to recover. We're rebuilding everything. New show as we've been going is called the ReAnimated Damn Studio. Works for me too, you know. So, because I'm a cyborg now, I have a pacemaker. So, you know, we're going to see about other parts later on just for the fun of it. Okay. On this flashback and credit to some of the original people that used to work with me. No one said it'd be easy. Hello. This time we're going to make sure you get that contact information. That's damstudio@netscape.net. It's damstudio@netscape.net. We also have Frau Morgan at myspace.com.
I could do the Planet of the Apes
thing.
How does that work?
See, it's
hard. I just have to stay tight on it.
I got a frog. Wait. Don't
worry. I hope you enjoy this. Let's go.
When we show you the art in King County that no one else will show you, good or bad.
Superheroes just need a little bit more training sometimes.
Yeah, I thought it had a happy ending. Hey, let us know what you like and what you dislike and what you want to see by checking out our website at
www.geocities.com/studio_damn_studio/.
This guy scares me. Send all your love letters or death threats to Damn Studio. Pick a favorite video and we'll show it on next week's show. And if you want, we'll even say who chose it.
Damn Studio. Now, see, really what it is people hate us.
Well, hello, Misty. Been a while. Guess you wanted to see an upgrade on some of the stuff that's been going on here at the studio. So we're down here in the basement.
Razor's Edge!
Here's one since we've had that we've had since redo. Great stuff, man. He's funny.
I like it a lot.
Some of the stuff we did before, some of the stuff that has you in it, and then some of the newer stuff we have done. So yeah, I can show people, kind of remember what we've done. We care about you. We love you. Hopefully we'll see you sometime soon. Goodbye. For now.
Girl, was
it? It's a
long-term fans of the Mortal Kombat fighting style games, here's a much earlier version. Not actually fully do that at all, but it's a fighting game style sample done on a computer, of course, where it puts can't use that where the characters meet and they kind of circle a little bit, but gives a feel, and you know that's sometimes all someone does for a game is they just do those scenes. So it kind of gives that ability. See, the idea was find what you can do and showcase it. Now a lot of this stuff is from early 2000s, if not like late 90s. So, you know, but hey, it gives you where it all started. We already know now they can do incredible stuff like Avatar and all that. This is what someone can do at home alone on their computer. You just learn how to apply it to whatever you want. So, on we go. Valley of Yuchim Co. Last sample tonight. This one is kind of a warning for you to remind you of household cleaning things from the dino with the big head. That's what I said, the dino with the big head. There you go.
Little reminder from the dino with the big head is brought to you by Little Chan and the owl.
Hey kids, remember what mom always says?
Always
keep the toilet clean.
This is how you do it. Watch.
I said, here's some of the props for our later thing. You know, well, I enjoy that. When you don't, you see a little bit of there, you saw Soren. Soren was a cameraman, became stage producer. Sometimes went and got, you know, if you're a local band in Seattle at the time we were doing the show, they'd call him, he'd go shoot their stuff. If you remember seeing the episode, they had the Elo Diaz stuff. That was his filming. He also used to go down to the schools during the graduation and film their work, just because, you know, it was all visual stuff, all pictures. So they didn't have the stuff to put it on video for us, but we wanted to show their stuff. So what he did is kind of a montage, went down there, filmed their table, their presentation table at their graduation, what they would show of their work to hopefully get jobs, or at least make their first impression into the industry. And these are some of the tapes that kind of between things got misplaced and lost or something, because some of these you'll see I've not seen until now. There was a big move in between there. And basically these were all on a Hi-8 tape, which for a long time I didn't have the equipment anymore to play. As the problems of format just becoming obsolete. In case of the VCR tapes. Now, these were one other one of Soren's Lost Tapes. I think there's about three samples there. These are all from the Art Institute of Seattle. If you're a local artist in your school, if you want to like get a hold of us, we have the information here and there throughout the show. To email us, we'll start a dialogue, see where we want to meet. Hey, if you're really interested, we can even talk to some of the schools and come in and work out a project or something. Put everything together, show everyone stuff, get them a first plug to being seen. But it also gives them a little bit of esteem as far as, you know, it's one thing being an artist. Another thing you can tell people, you've had your stuff seen on TV. Maybe public access, but you can leave that part out if you want. But it's a chance for those of us that don't have the bucks to buy the time and the commercials. We can get your stuff seen. So, enjoy.
I'd like to explain basically what you've been looking at and what we do here. We
also show you how you can take simple pictures, scan them in or create them in the computer, piece them together to tell your story.
You've been seen normally, brought from the schools, colleges, people that didn't even go to school, that just did their stuff at home, decided they wanted to take the chance to have
some storytelling. What all media is a form of telling stories. We'd like to get your stories. Various types, because you've got to see all the
issues. You know, chance to create something and have it on the air. So, you know, and I'd like to get more affiliated with some of the high schools in the area. See, I went to high school down here. And I'd like to see more stuff, this time from the high school.
Whether you're just an artist, don't have the stories, just take your stuff, put it together, a little montage.
Still good. Anyone. You know, if you have something, let us see it. We'll put it on the air. Watch us, because we'll watch
it. Pick something you like, and just kind of put your art together, and you can flow it together, or just have it cut together,
contact
however you want to do it.
At damstudio@netscape.net.
Photoshop, Premiere, whatever programming, video editing program. Today, it's a lot easier. Our formats we accept are like VCR tape.
Yeah, contact us, let us know what you'd like to see, and probably maybe we can best help you out.
Bunch of AVIs. Place on CD.
Even like set up a website where people that have the stuff and the desire will be able to contact others that have the ideas and the drive to maybe put something together. I think a lot of good things can be created out of this.
We'll try to find a way to get it together on there and put it on the air for you. So you can see it, your friends can see it.
In this area. You know, everywhere I went, piece that goes with me, and people like the stuff I was doing and showing. This show has some of our stuff from the studio and stuff from the old show, which was a lot.
Mine were good on a resume, your stuff appeared on TV.
No matter what it is, we'd like to see it, we'd like to put it on the air, we'd like to let other people see it. We'll let you know when it's at, when we're going to be on, when we're going to show it, so we don't miss it. Tell your friends and everyone, they can see it. It'll be a whole generation of local bands. We'd like to use some of your music. Everything we could get locally. The art from here, we see it here.
Thank you. You're probably wondering why I brought you here.
Well, got there again. Hope you enjoyed what you've seen. Over at the end of the show. Of course, we'll have another one. Piece them together when we can. Put them on the air. Even put them together. Maybe someday they'll be available here and there. We are, as you've seen earlier, on live stream. YouTube. We're still catching up, though, to the newer episodes. But we got to put the older stuff out there first. Not everyone's been watching, you know, loyally. But we'll get there. Took about 2-3 years in Seattle before we became real popular, but public access was more of an issue there. More people were into it. Here, not as much, but it still gives us all the chances we need and the opportunity to learn. If you just have questions about doing something in public access, contact us through the email and we'll put you in touch with the people. Same with Nat's a film stuff he does. He's got a project right now he's working on in over there at West Richland, I believe. He had one that was also on the air, and I'll try to get that copy of that for you to see. Well, sure, when I was, he was the producer of it. I don't have the full details of that, but I was going to go to a meeting with him and some other people. It's not just a private meeting or anything, it's a public thing. Sometimes catch us at Hastings over there in Richland, drinking coffee and talking concepts. Want to get involved, let us know. We'll plug you in that direction too. If you want to do these things, you got to get involved. I'd love to create a small, filming group. Not so sure, but, collective. Filming is the most expressive form of a collaborative art form. Many people are involved. Many people do things. You have costuming, you have makeup, you have acting, you have writers, you have artists just writing storyboards, you got prop designers, you have people looking for locations. If you're fancy enough, you got auto wrangler, pet wrangler, people that find the cars for the scenes. It's just got so much. And if you're just interested in doing it, it could be fun. I can't promise any money. I don't make anything doing this yet. But I enjoy doing it. That's why I'm here, and hopefully that's why you're here watching. So, we're on twice a week. You can catch us again. The times have been shown throughout the show. I'm sure you're probably getting tired of that. Catch us again. Look on 9913. You can see us on the TV guide. They list the shows. That's Damn Studio in case you came in really late. And thanks for being here. Farewell.